We're going to start this with a cotton swab, getting some of the surface grime off. This bobbin case is pretty grungy. So I put it into my small Stanley machinist vise. Now, if you're going to put it into a vise like this, and I highly recommend doing that, don't crank it in super tight. Just hold it firm enough so that it's not going to wiggle around on you. The two screws have to come out so we can remove the spring. The first screw that comes off, of course, is the adjustment screw. It's the larger of the two. If you look at the spring, it's the one that has the raised boss around the screw head. Well, if you want to call that a screw head. It's not much of a head, actually. Anyway, it can be a little tricky. Sometimes they can be a little stiff. And you might want to use a pair of tweezers like I am here to help stabilize that screw so you can grab it and not lose it. I, of course, always have a little plastic container to put these tiny, tiny parts in as I'm disassembling. And you see here, I grabbed the screw with the tweezer, and I've got a little yellow bin, and knock it in, and there it goes. And the next one to come out is the actual mounting screw for the spring. That one's even tinier and can be even more of a pain in the patoots to get off. Be very careful you don't lose these. If you do, you're gonna be in a world of hurt, because you're not gonna find these screws anywhere without, you know, buying another bobbin case. So just be very, very careful. And here I'm taking the screw and the spring at the same time. Everything goes into the little parts container, and we'll get the vise out of the way, and we're gonna work on the body of the bobbin case first. Now, you can see there's still quite a bit of grungy stuff on there. And yeah, I could put it in the ultrasonic, but I'm choosing to do this with just rotary tools, Q-tips, and a little bit of elbow grease. So we're going to go in there. I shouldn't say Q-tip. That's a name brand. This is a cotton swab, an industrial cotton swab. It's got a lot harder pack of cotton than a household Q-tip does. They do a great job taking that grunge off, or at least loosening it up off the surface. So I'm going into my selection of rotary tool bits, and I've got a hard felt cylinder there. And I'm going to change that off on the rotary tool. And once I get that on there, I'm going to charge it up with some white compound. And then we're going to go to town on this puppy. So I've got the rotary tool moving at about half speed. You could go quicker if you want. It just generates a tremendous amount of friction. Of course, friction is heat. And it all depends upon how much you want to deal with your fingertips feeling like they're on fire from these things. Pardon the sarcasm. But go through and clean every surface. Now, I'm going to be changing tools several times throughout this. I try to get every area of the case that I can reach. Now, the little recessed area that the hook rides in, prior to shooting this, I hit that with a very fine wire wheel. I did not get footage of that. My apologies. But one of the smaller wire wheels that comes with the Harbor Freight set of five, I got into that groove and cleaned any crud out of the groove with that on my flexible shaft tool. But regardless, we're going to be polishing the rest of this. There's a couple of areas that you really need to concentrate on as far as the polishing goes. Of course, one area is inside where the bobbin itself actually rides. And the other area is on the other main area on the body, I should say, is on the exterior where the spring attaches. And I'm going to be working my way around to that very, very shortly here. And the reason for getting this is this is part of the thread path right here where I'm working. That's where the spring is going to go. So we want that super clean, super shiny underneath that spring. And of course, when time comes, we're going to clean both sides of the spring as well. And I'll show you how we're going to do that. We're going to use some non-marring pliers to hold that part. But in the interim, let's go ahead and continue to polish the bobbin case body itself. It's important when you're doing the inside where the bobbin rides to get some compound on the end of the tool so you can get that lip on the inside. Now I'm switching to a larger polishing point and getting in there. It's a little bit more efficient going with a larger point for doing this inside. But I'm making sure to get some compound on the end so that inner lip is getting cleaned and polished as well. And once again, polish, polish, polish. It's the story of my life. And we'll move over and just take a piece of blue paper towel and wipe off some buffing dirt. But we can use the blue paper towel to hold this because it's getting bloody hot at this point. And, it'll help stabilize it. Now, I've switched over to a bigger hard felt wheel. And I'm just going to go around and do some more polishing on the body itself. And you'll see it starting to come up nice and shiny now. And we're going to continue polish, 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 because that's all I seem to do. And once again, any surface that is in the thread path has to be polished completely. Any area where it's going to be rubbing up against the bobbin case positioning bracket, we want to get that nice and clean. And then we'll go over it once again with paper towel and with Q-tips and get off the buffing dirt. And there's quite a bit of dirt there. Buffing compound, it forms a black, not really a goo, but it's a black film that just, it wipes right off, but you got to get it off. And I like to get in there with firm cotton type cotton swabs and clean that mess out as best as humanly possible. And you could put it into an ultrasonic and clean that off too. I just try to avoid using the ultrasonic for bobbin cases. And we just keep on cleaning and cleaning and wiping. You can see I'm pulling out a lot of buffing dirt. This whole process took about what it's taking for you to see do this. I've done very little editing on this for time. This is getting voiced over because, once again, it is excruciatingly hot in the shop right now, and I had to have fans running. And between the fans and the sounds of the rotary tools, if I was talking to you while I was doing this, you wouldn't have heard a thing I was saying. So it's just as well. Now's the fun time. It's that little spring. And believe me, this can be a challenge. It's going to hit the outside of it just ever so lightly. No pressure with the larger tool. And I'm going to switch over and take a more cylindrical, finer tool. As you can see, I grabbed one there. That's the one I was using earlier. And I'm going to grab a pair of non-marring pliers. And I'm going to hold that spring. And you're going to see how I'm going to be able to position it. Now, you got to be careful that you don't deform that spring. You don't want to bend it and deform it. You just want to secure it. You want to hold it. And you use very, very light pressure. I wouldn't even use pressure. I just say touch it to the spinning buffing wheel, and it'll clean the crud off real fast. Let the compound do the work. You don't have to use pressure on this. Just takes a little light touch, and boom, that stuff just wipes right off. And then we'll flip it around and we'll do the outside a little bit more and clean up some of the other crud. And then it will be time to reassemble, which that's why we have the vise, is for the disassembly and the reassembly, because you're going to need to hold that steady. I've done it without using a vise. It is not any fun whatsoever. These are the most challenging parts of a Model 66, bar none, is these two screws on this bobbin case. Now, reassembly is reverse of disassembly, so we're going to be putting that tiny, tiny screw in first. And here's a case where I mean, I'm not big on magnetic screwdrivers, but here's a case where I was actually thankful that my screwdriver has been magnetized in the past, the one that I use, because I was able to get that screw to stay on the end of the screwdriver. My apologies here if my fingers get in the way. This is so delicate. And try to do this without breathing. Now, the end of that, the spring does hook into that one hole in the bobbin case. You noticed that when you took it apart, I'm sure. Once again, pardon my hand. It'll get out of your way here in a moment. But you'll see this is a very, very delicate operation. And that screw is absolutely minuscule. So get it in, heave a heavy sigh of relief. And it's time to go to the adjusting screw, which is a little bit easier to do. But it still can be a pain in the patoots. So its shape is what actually makes it a little bit more difficult than the tiny one. But getting it in place with a pair of tweezers and then getting in there with a screwdriver and getting it tightened up. Sorry, I couldn't do this and get a good camera angle on it. But there you go. It's in. We'll adjust tension on that when it comes time to put it back into the machine and make the adjustments on the machines. But there you have it, a clean and polished Singer 66 class bobbin case. And that's what I got for you on this one. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.